We're joined by Tim Boyle ahead of the NCAA Tournament. Wingate getting set to take on UIndy Sunday, 4 o'clock. Coach, your initial thoughts on the matchup and what's going to be the biggest key for your team's success on Sunday?
Well, initial thoughts are we're excited and blessed to have the opportunity to continue playing. We've had a couple of long breaks here, so to get back and get on the field against someone else is going to be really fun for us. UIndy's a great team. Coach Docks does an amazing job. His kids are well-coached. They play hard. They're amazing at not ever getting flustered, and it amazes me every year when I watch them. They play poised at all times, no matter what the score is, and that's a tribute to him and his coaching staff. So we're excited about the matchup, and we're pumped to be able to play in the NCAAs, and hopefully we'll be able to make the university, make the alumni proud.
You mentioned the time, the weird time off with two plus weeks off between the regular season finale and then the SAC tournament, and then you have 16 plus days off between the SAC championship game and this game. What's been your biggest challenge, and how have you approached this awkward sort of time where you've had some time off and then you played two games in 3 days? What's been the message and the approach during this time?
Yeah, it's difficult when you think about it. I mean, when you go 14 plus days and then play two games in 3 days and then you have 20 days for the next, it's a difficult scenario. And keeping kids motivated is always a challenge in that situation. You have finals, the weather is getting nice, so there's a lot of things that don't come into play. We've tried to keep it as simple as possible. We toned down exactly how long we practice. We cut them down to an hour and a half, and we wanted them to concentrate on their academics and concentrate on their finals more so than anything else. At this point in the year, I mean, they know the system. They know what they need to do. We wanted to, make sure we got healthy. We wanted to make sure we tried to just keep them sharp, but we also didn't want to overdo it with them. And we really concentrated on being intense, being organized, being structured for a quick hour and a half every day, and not doing too much on top of that, so they can really focus on finishing out their academic year on a high note.
What was your biggest takeaway from the SAC tournament, and how has that sort of addressed what you all needed to work on and build upon in these weeks of practice building up to this game?
Well, staying sharp was the number one thing, because we found that, the beginning of the Limestone game, we were pretty sharp, and then at some point that layoff found its way into our game, and we struggled, and then having just the one-day rest in between Limestone and LR and having such a hard game against Limestone, it showed itself in our LR game. And I think for us, our face-off unit that was doing very well all year long ran into kind of a wall and struggled for two games, and it was something that we weren't prepared for, and I take that as my fault that we needed to get better at that. So we've been concentrating on that and trying to figure out better ways to counter and better ways to get that ball to a 50-50 and get that ball off the carpet and get it to our strength, which is our attack unit. So we've been really working on that last couple of weeks, and we know that if we can do that, we're in a good position, and if we struggle at the faceoffs again, it's going to put a lot of stress on us.
You mentioned the attack with led by Bobby Patton, Adam Vodobnik, Willie Greco, and a number of other guys that can score the ball. But when you focus on those three guys, I know we've talked about it a number of times, but how would you describe that trio, and have you had a trio that dynamic in the past, whether it was Wingate or at Dowling?
No, I don't remember ever having a trio that dynamic, to be honest with you. When you've got two strong Dodgers, that's a great thing. But then when you have that third finisher, I mean, that just adds to it. And when you've got a kid like Willie who's got such great vision, and you've got such a tough kid, tough as nails Dodger like Bobby who can really get to the front, and he's also got great vision, it's great to have. And then having Adam on the inside who just is so slippery and is able to find those little areas, and he can get his shot off so quickly, it really is a very dynamic group. And I really don't remember. I mean, I've had some good units over the times as a coach, and I'm fortunate for that, but this is a pretty dynamic unit.
Now you run the defense, and the defense has been strong this year. What's been your message to the team on the defensive side of the ball entering this game against UIndy?
We have to get back to controlling the tempo. So I believe we kind of lost sight of that We lost sight of sliding at proper moments too. So we were really focusing on that for this last couple of weeks, on getting back to engaging Dodgers, trying to get them to their weakness, not worrying about taking the ball away too much, but worrying about putting them in frustrating situations. And then hopefully when they do get the leverage that we don't desire, then we have to slide appropriately. And those are things that we weren't doing well in the SAC tournament, and we need to get back to doing those well.
What are your thoughts on the field in the South region, the five teams, and overall what it's going to take for your team to advance as far as possible?
I think it's going to take a lot. Again, UIndy is such a great team, and they've got some really strong NCAA experience and getting past the first round. And I think for us, you know, that having that scenario where we haven't been able to come out of that first round of the NCAAs yet is something that, you know, we don't want to dwell upon it too much. We don't want to harp on it, but, you know, we got to do it. And we've got to prove some people wrong. And that's fine by us, because we've been proving people wrong for a long time, and we're okay with that. But we've got to make sure that we just play our game, concentrate on the important things, don't get caught up in the little things, and get the 50-50 ground balls, get the ball our offense, take a lot of shots, limit the shots on the defensive side, have strong wing play, have strong face-off play, have some good saves in the net. And I think then it's going to be a strong game. It's going to be a good game for both teams. And I think we're evenly matched. And I know it's going to be a fun game, and it's going to be an exciting game. And the rest of the field is strong. I mean, Tampa, to be the five seed and be Tampa is kind of crazy. But I think it just had to do with the COVID things, and that's just where their numbers fell. But you could argue that they're the best team in the field. You could argue that LR is the best team in the field. So one's a one and one's a five. So it's crazy. And there were other teams that you know, could have came in too. Lindenwood, Belmont Abbey, there was a bunch of teams out there. Lynn, that had strong years. It's difficult, you know, with COVID and getting cut a couple of teams in the tournament. And so it's going to be interesting to see. And then obviously the North has got a tremendous, you know, group in the five that they have there. So we're just really excited for the opportunity to get to, anytime you can get to play in May, as a college lacrosse player, you've got to be pumped.
Well, Coach, we certainly wish you nothing but the best. Good luck on Sunday, and we look forward to watching your team play.
You got it. Thanks.